You might well wonder why I'm sitting here on this glorious day in this lovely swing seat. It all happened just over 14 years ago that my son Richard decided to go around the world in a balloon. I mean, I ask you, but we were used to his silly little adventures. And this one proved to be very, very difficult, but very fulfilling, because he decided to start away in Morocco. Now, in those days, 14 years ago, people didn't seem to know much about Morocco. So we came here, and while we were waiting for the weather window to be right for him and his little balloon to get around the world, there was time for me to kill. And while I was killing time, a lovely Moroccan friend of mine said, "Eve, quickly, come up the mountains. Come up to the higher Atlas Mountains. There's a castle for sale." So, of course, up I go. And there, this lovely Casbah Tamanot was standing idle. And he said, this chap, this lovely Moroccan, he said, "But Eve, you've got to say, within a week, we've got to buy it within a week. Ask Richard." So I got my photographs out and I shoved them under his paper. And I said, "Richard, you've got to buy it and you've only got a week. Just look, it's wonderful." "Oh, Mum," he said. He closed his newspaper. He said, "I've got to get off to work." I said, "But you've got to say yes within a week." "Oh, all right," he said as he stormed out to his office. I was so happy. I rang up the man in Morocco. I said, "He said yes, hoo-hoo." Anyhow, that was the long and the short of it was. He bought it. But there was a condition. The condition was that I would take on all the villages around this beautiful hotel. I said, yes, I would. Hence, I'm here now, working away in my villages, and I'm hoping to take you chaps with me, because all these villages need money, and this is a voluntary job for me. And so my only way was to ask you chaps to come with me, see the villages, and see if you decide that they're worth helping. About 6 years ago, the challenge was on. And I thought, well, where do I start to teach these girls? And 4 years ago, you'll see how we achieved a lovely craft house over in Tanskart. They left school at 13. None of them knew any. They had no more education until they got married. That was their life. So I thought, well, I don't know. I better teach myself to knit, which I did. And I bought out some knitting needles and some wool. And I went over and made friends with a granny in the village opposite. And I hope you're going to come to this village to see. So there they were, three girls turned up, sat on the floor, because there was no chairs or anything in these little village houses. And I sat with them, saying, "Pearl, plain." And they got quite excited. But I forgot to tell them how to cast off. But never mind, I'm sure they're still knitting a lovely long scarf.
An old boat. What is a boat? So this is a boat, okay?
Answer the math question.
We're teaching them to speak English.
So what did you call him? What did they tell him when he couldn't swim? The professor. Yeah. So what lesson did you call him? You have.
They never ask for anything, which is so wonderful. They're too proud to ask. And I suddenly realized that there was nothing to take them to hospital. The pregnant ladies had nowhere to go. And so, thanks to once more to your money, we managed to buy them an ambulance, which we see coming backwards and forwards So it is working well. So I'm going to take you to three of our villages that I've taken on, and I hope you'll enjoy coming with me.
Hello. Hello. I see, they look good. They're looking fine.
Oh dear, I get the silly ideas in the middle of the night. Well, I think my girls ought to have cashmere goats to enhance them, lovely white cashmere goats. Well, that idea sounded all right, and a friend of mine, she breeds them in England. So I said, can I have 30 of your cashmere goats? And she said, oh yes, she was only too glad. She wanted to retire and get shot of them. So I bought 30 cashmere goats. You might think that was easy. It then took me 2 years to get permission to get my goats from there to here. I mean, in the end, I was so desperate. Either our government wouldn't allow it, or the Moroccan government wouldn't allow it. And this went backwards and forwards. And finally, I had to bring in the big guns and ask my son, Richard, please, Richard, please, I've got 30 goats and I don't know what to do with them. They've got to get to Morocco. Oh, leave it to me, Mum. And a week later, permission came through.
What a noise! So, the other 50 more. 3 eggs. They're good? They're laying. It's quite a different way. In England, we never do it like this. So when they get
this is the Moroccan way, Berber way.
When they get 50 more, where are they going to be?
50 or on the other side, cannot see.
Other side.
You'll see this place is for the young one. Yeah. Okay? For this older one, to transfer them here.
Have you still got the rabbits under the
rabbits. On yesterday. Born yesterday.
Look, yesterday. And who would think a rabbit's going to look like that one day? Oh, look, there's a mummy.
Themselves, we'll help them help themselves. And it seems to be working. And so the whole challenge is really on. There's no ending. I'm wanting to take on another village, which I hope to take you to, in the higher Atlas Mountains.
Welcome.
Ça va? It's coming, it's getting there nearer, closer.
But I'll take you up and see that, and I want to you just to see these girls, because they are like my other first village, who are starting off with nothing. And I'm going to take some knitting needles up and a bit of wool, and we'll start them off on the ground, and you'll see what I'm trying to achieve. And I hope to take on more villages.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
don't want anybody handing money. They must earn their money, or we're going to lose the wonderful atmosphere that we've got over there. Never a day goes by that I don't think, how can I better it? They are rolling on, my projects.